to start my talk off today by telling you guys a story about this guy right here. Now, I know the quality sucks, but you can still tell my hair is whack in that photo. Don't ask me what was going on there. But the reason I'm showing you this, and the reason that I'm looking down there, is because that was me currently prepping and practicing for my piano recital, okay? Now, when I tell you guys about piano recital, I'm not just talking about like a piano recital, I'm talking about the piano recital. Like, this is the final boss of piano recitals. So I knew I had to be tough, I had to get my piece down perfectly. And keep in mind, I'm going in blind here, right? I have no music sheets or anything, so I had to get this down perfectly. So that week before, I got everything down, like note for note, bar for bar, it was perfect. If you saw me, I looked like the LeBron of piano players, guys. Like, I had my stuff down. But I was just so incredibly nervous because I knew there was that possibility of failure that I could mess up and all eyes would be on me. So going into that day, I put my suit on and I'm going in the car, going to that performance, and I'm just shaking the whole time. I'm so nervous, I just can't get it off of me. And I sit down and I see everyone go in front of me and they're all doing it perfectly. So I know, like, I gotta match that. I gotta have that same energy. And finally it's my turn, they call my name. I walk up on there and I sit down and it's silent. All right, all eyes are on me, it's time to go. And I start to play my piece and I just mess up like the first three notes. So it's like, okay, like let's run that back real quick. I keep playing it and I just keep messing up like the first five notes and I just can't get past it. So it feels like forever. I just and keep playing that beginning and beginning, I can't get past it. And finally, my piano teacher has to walk up all the way across the room and put my music sheets on, so I'm definitely not feeling like LeBron now. All eyes are on me, and don't worry, not that bad. I was able to finish with the music sheets. And I know you're wondering why I'm telling you about my sorry piano playing. Promise, it has a purpose. But before I get to that, message, I want to give you a background on that fear I felt and what was going on in my brain. So this is our brain here, and I want to talk about one thing in particular, which is our amygdala. Now, our amygdala is that part in our brain which is known for recognizing our emotions and one in particular, which is fear. So anytime it recognizes this fear, it will alert our nervous system and will start to release our stress hormones, right? So, and a lot of the times, it will put ourselves into our flight or flight, right? And this is super important, right? Because if we're in these dire situations, this fight or flight mode is what kept humans alive. It's what keeps us safe, right? Like, if you're in the forest and you see a bear, I'm not going to tell you to, you know, talk to that bear and go confront your fears. Like, you know, you need to do what you need to do to get out of it, right? So that fight or flight mode is something that protects us. But our amygdala starts to restrict us when we're trying to grow and we're trying to change and when that fear is involved. And I like to think of it by using this guy over here, whose name is literally fear. So if you've watched Inside Out, you know that fear over here, who's in the main character's brain, Riley, has one job, and one job in particular, and that's to recognize and eliminate any sense of fear, stress, or discomfort in the human, right? So a lot of times, this is gonna be really important, right? Like in those situations with the bear, he's gonna get you out of it, right? So he's gonna be incredibly useful in these scary situations, but he's also gonna restrict you when you're trying to grow, when you're trying to learn, and when you're trying to change. Because he's gonna wanna put you in those most comfortable situations. If he sees any sort of discomfort within you, he's gonna wanna get you out of there, right? So whether it's in that scary situation, or just giving a talk in front of an audience, speaking in front of the class, doing something that gives you any ounce of discomfort, he's gonna wanna get you out of there. All right, so now let's go back to that week of the recital, right? I had my piece down, it was perfect. My body was telling me I had it down, right? Like every time I played it, I had it perfectly, but my brain saw a stressful situation. It had seen possible failure. It saw that, you know what, it's a real possibility that you just messed that up. And it told me, you're gonna fail, you're just gonna mess up. And I mean, I guess my brain was onto something, because I did fail. But that failure helped me in two big ways, with my motivation and in my mindset leading into this year. And one thing was really putting importance and equating that fear of embarrassment or that fear of failure that we so often feel, right? Because for me especially, I put way too much emphasis and importance on that failure. I'm always picturing the worst case scenario, right? I put too much importance on what others think, right? Like, not that I don't value what others think of me, it's just that I'm always thinking all eyes are on me, I'm always thinking the worst case scenario, right? Like, that week, I was so unbelievably stressed out. You'd have thought that, like, Thanos was coming to end the world, and I was the only one left. Like, it was pretty bad. My brain was in, like, shambles. So part of dealing with that fear and getting better was really asking myself, is the worst all that bad? And putting a value to that worst case scenario. And that second mindset change was realizing I could either use this fear to restrict me, to hold me back as I had, or I could use it to push me forward. I could use it to tell me that I was onto something, because I'm not gonna feel this fear, I'm not gonna feel this stress, this discomfort, if I wasn't growing, if I wasn't changing. So it was about winning that battle in my head and telling myself that, you know what, I'm gonna embrace that and I'm still gonna do this anyways. But part of winning that battle in your head and being comfortable with that fear is that it's so hard to do, guys. And an example of this guy over here. Now, I know it looks like I'm modeling for Vogue or something, but that was me running for fifth grade president. Now, fifth grade me was able to, you know, silence that voice in his head. He was able to tell himself, you know, I'm gonna do this, I'm gonna recognize that losing is possible, but I'm gonna do this anyways, because that's what's best. The problem is, sixth grade, seventh grade, eighth grade, ninth grade, and 10th grade me weren't able to do the same. And it took me up until this year to run again, not because I didn't want it, but because I was scared, right? I recognized in all those years that losing was possible, right? That I could lose, that was a big possibility, that could have happened, and I saw that, and I decided, you know what, I'm just not gonna do it. So it was about winning that battle in my head. But winning that battle is not gonna come easy, right? Like, a lot of the times before I have these big speeches, anything that gives me stress, I just tell myself, I look in the mirror and I just say, you know what, like, chill out, bro. You got this, you're gonna be good. Just don't stress, like, you're good. And then, like, that's what I was doing in the dressing room. I was telling myself, like, you got this, like, just chill out, you're not gonna be nervous. Then I come up here and I'm incredibly nervous, right? Like, it just doesn't work. It just doesn't go away like that. So part of getting better with your fears, part of dealing with that, is recognizing and embracing that fear, right? Knowing that you're not gonna change, you're not gonna grow, and you're not gonna become your best self if that fear is not present, right? So it's important to recognize that, and it's important to embrace that fear is there, but pushing yourself anyways. But it's also important to know that it is you who should be in control, not fear. Because if fear is in that driver's seat, if fear is telling you what to do, it's gonna put you in that comfortable situation. It's gonna put you where you're at ease, where you're not challenging yourself. So it's important to take fear out of that driver's seat and put yourself into control. Now, I wanna end this talk off by giving a quote from, well, my biggest inspiration, but I think truly one of life's biggest inspirations, Master Oogway. Now, if you guys haven't watched Kung Fu Panda, you guys know what you're doing when you go home. If you have watched Kung Fu Panda, you know that Po, the main character, was selected to be the dragon warrior, okay? He had to protect the Valley of Peace. He had a big job ahead of him. And as you can guess, he was so scared about all the possibilities that happened. He had questions, he had so many fears. He just wanted to go back to making new moves. You know, that was what kept him at peace. That was what kept him comfortable. He didn't want to challenge himself. So with all this on his mind, with all this on his brain, he went to go to Master Oogway, and he asked him for some piece of advice. And this is what he told him. He said, quit, don't quit. Noodles, don't noodles. You're too concerned with what was and what will be. Yesterday is a mystery. Yesterday is history. Tomorrow is a mystery. But today is a gift. That's why we call it the present. And right, and that's what I'm telling you guys, right? There's always gonna be those question marks. There's always gonna be those possibilities, those what ifs. There's always gonna be those surrounding you. But it's time to embrace that and put put yourself in control. So, besides watching Kung Fu Panda, my question to you guys is,